Hello, it's Monday evening and you've just enjoyed your first day back in virtual Uppingham. Normally, I'd have filmed this last week, but of course we were all waiting for this afternoon to see what the Prime Minister would say to us. Well, as far as I'm concerned, it was really great news. It means that Uppingham can reconvene on the 8th of March and that you can return to school, presuming that is, of course, you're in the position to be able to make it back. And for those of you overseas, I want to say something specific to you a little bit later on. So what does this mean in practice? Well, it means that we've got two more weeks of virtual Uppingham. But with light at the end of the tunnel, you can go doubly hard at it and give it all your energy, knowing that you'll be back in the classroom learning in the best possible way shortly. So of course, on the 7th, on that Sunday, we'll run our testing programs. You're all used to that now. And Mr. Wilding was right with details as to how that looks in the course of the next few days. But the really great news is, for those of you who can make it, we can be back in Uppingham once more in the next fortnight. I want to say something to those of you who are overseas. I imagine there's a real mixture of emotions, a genuine delight that Uppingham's opening for 2 weeks at the end of this term, but a sadness that you probably won't be able to join us. We know how difficult overseas travel is at the moment, flying in, quarantine hotels, am I on the country that is red-listed or not? These are really difficult decisions to take. And of course, from our point of view, we want to make that as easy a decision as it possibly can be. So we'll lay on hybrid teaching. You'll be able to join all your lessons using cameras, seeing exactly what's going on, and pick up recorded lessons afterwards. We'll do our best to make sure you don't feel left out. There'll be a sense where the house comes together on Zoom meetings, your husums and your tutors will stay in touch, and of course your friends here will make sure that they reach out to you to let you know that you really are truly missed. Remember, we've made the summer term longer so that we can get you all back for a really good length of time. That decision was taken knowing that many of you would find it hard to fly back in March. And at least there's some comfort knowing that the summer term will be even more open, all being well, than the 2 weeks we're going to get in March. And we will have, I hope, a fabulous time. I imagine some of your parents are wondering about quarantine regulations. Well, so are we. We'd love to know exactly what the story is, and I hope that over the course of the next few weeks we get some clarity. And trust me, as ever, the minute that we get clarity, we will share that with you. But we will make your lives as easy as they possibly can be in getting you back in time for that summer term. But make the most of the fact that these 4 weeks are ones where we can do some quality learning, whether we're in the UK, whether we're on virtual Uppingham, whether we're at school, or whether we're overseas. It really matters to us that you know that we are thinking of you. There's one outstanding thing, of course. Those of you in the upper sixth and the upper fifth, you're still asking the question, what is going to happen this summer instead of exams? Well, the news is that we're going to find out on Thursday. Ofqual plan to publish the outcome of their consultation, and we should have some definitive information later this week. As ever, you'll be the first to know once we've got those details. So there we are. We got our announcement today, and I think it was good news. Good news because it seems across the country things are moving in the right direction. Good news for us because it means that we can resume in school for all year groups on the 8th of March. It's the best we could have possibly hoped for, I think, given everything we knew in January. So it's really exciting to know that in 2 weeks' time, those of you that can make it back will be here renewing friendships, learning in lessons, playing sport, being involved in music and drama. And it was great to hear a real emphasis on young people getting out there and being involved in sport once more. We know how much it really matters. So power on through this week. Give it everything you've got. And next Monday, we'll be commending those of you who've done really well in the first 5 weeks of term. Uppinghamians across the world have had to cope with so much over the course of the last year. And I know you've put your heads down and given it your all. And Mr. Cooper's crunching his sums and organising his algorithms. And we'll be able to commend those of you who've done especially well at the start of next week. But for now, let's make the most of the few days we've got ahead of us. I know you'll put your effort in. And it's great to know that in 2 weeks' time, we'll have you back at school again.